you were doing this exercise at home, it's ideal for warming the horse's muscles up before jumping. It's excellent for the horse's hoof-brain coordination. It develops the horse's core muscles by tightening its tummy muscles up and loosening its back muscles. And it also helps you teach the horse directional aids over a fence eventually. Here I've used three variations. I have raised poles, dressage boards, or blocks of square poles that actually all of them don't move. So that encourages the horse to draw back and use its shoulder and develop its core. So when you first use this exercise, go in a straight line, use a focal point as you see Roz doing, looking towards the direction she's going. That will help the horse use its own balance and it will help it develop its rhythm and use the poles effectively. You can see here, Ben just drops his head and the horse rushes a little bit, and that's because he's losing his balance. Here, we look at the rider's eyesight. So as you see Roz coming through to this, she's got her eye looking up to the direction of movement, and this will help keep the horse in balance and allow the horse to use its own balance and feel its rhythm. Here, Ben just drops his head a little bit, and you can see how that just drops the rider's shoulders, and he loses his position a little bit because of that and collapses through his core. So here's a variation of the exercise, and here's a very good example of the rider teaching the horse to turn. So there she's asking the horse to start the turn through pole two and then keep it established through three, and the horse will know where she's going by the pole four. So the important thing here are the turning aids, and this is where the eye comes in. You use your eye to turn first. You drop the weight down the new inside heel, keep your inside shoulder forward, and take your outside rein to meet your inside rein. She's told the horse and she's given the instructions on the turn. This is really important because it's the first building block to telling a horse where to go over a fence. You can see there the withers turned and the horse really knew where she was going. So in contrast to that, here we see a perfect example of the rider a little bit late looking to where he's going and therefore going to the inside aids and losing the outside shoulder. So by the time he gets to the boards, or if it's a jump, you'll find that you'll be out of balance. So here you see Roz in slow motion, and you can see here from a side-on view, there's no resistance in the turn. The horse accepts the aids, the turning aids that Roz is very consistent with, and the horse is happy about making that turn and staying in balance. With this exercise, it's really important to set up early. Ben was a little bit late in making that turn, so therefore the horse was going out through the outside shoulder. If that was a fence, you'd be in danger of having the fence down or even having a run out to the right. So the main points to remember here is maintaining your balance and rhythm as a rider, looking to the new direction so you ride those turning aids really effectively. Make sure you maintain the horse's energy levels so he can perform the exercise correctly. Be aware the horse might get tired, so make sure that you give him a break and praise and reward where necessary.